All right, so here's a recap of what we've done so far. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Drive Talk Cars. If this is your first time and you want to learn how to do your own maintenance to save some money, do your own mods and other car related activities, start now by clicking on that subscribe button as well as that notification bell. That way you don't miss out on anything. All right, so we've reached the final stage, part three of the series on how to change out the cam adjusters on your M156 AMG engine. So let's dive into it. All right, so when you take it out, you're gonna have this. It's the adjuster, is the bottom part. This part comes off. You set that to the side. And this is the main thing that we're focusing on. All right, so there's five bolts that you have to take off, and then it comes apart. We're gonna leave this on, which is in the previous video, you saw that we used this to lock up the gears. So what we're doing here, the object of taking it apart is to do what is called the pin flip. I can explain a little bit more once we get into the adjuster, but normally if you're going to replace this, you wouldn't do any of this. You would just take this whole piece here and you would replace it with a new one of these. That runs you about $690-$700, at least for the M156 engine adjuster, the AMG. So since I don't want to spend that much, I'm going to go ahead and attempt this pin flip trick. And I'll link the YouTuber that I got this idea from down below. He's a really genius when it comes to this M156 engines and German engines. All right, so we have these five bolts here we need to take off using a T30 socket torque bit. Now, this is probably gonna be a little hard because it's hard to get leverage on something that's full of oil. So, might have to bring out the big boy, but for right now, I have the smaller one. Also, being that you normally replace these, there is no torque specs for the bolt. So I think I'm gonna mark it so I'll know where it was, and in my head that makes sense and that I can torque it back to that mark. But if not, we will see. So first thing first, I need to wipe off the face and I'm just gonna mark it. I'm gonna find something on here as a reference point. It has letters on here, so maybe I'll just use the A for each bolt and that'll be the spot that I need to torque it down or mark it. All right, so I've marked it, and hopefully when I put it back in, I'll be able to torque it back to those spots. All right, so let's get this front plate off. Leverage is always, always your friend. Remember that. Don't have to be Hercules if you have leverage. All right, so we have the plate. Take that off. We have a piece of plastic that goes on top of the spring right there. We have a spring. Take these gloves off so you can see, so I can hold it. We have a spring, and then we have our plate here. this part here, there's a pin there, and when it's the spring pushes down on this pin, and when it's resting, the pin should go down into the slot, so this part right here doesn't move. You can see it. That's what's making the click clack sound, is that movement there. All right, so this pin here is what is the locking mechanism for when you're doing a cold startup. So what happens is the adjuster is not full of oil yet. I mean, there's oil in there, of course, but it's not full of oil. So this pin is in place. So when you start it up, it locks, and these part here doesn't move. So this back and forth is what makes the clanky sound. So this pin is only utilizing, or you're only utilizing maybe half the pin. So what you do is you flip it. Now, this is a new end, because remember, it's only using half of it. So that's the new end. When you put it down in the spot, everything's okay. So let's take it apart more so we can see the internals of this and get a better understanding. There's holes in here you can see, and once you line up that hole, it will come out. All right, so got that piece off. Now we just gotta get this middle piece out so I can examine and make sure that everything is okay. All right, so there you have it. When you put it back, you wanna make sure that this hole here is in the same slot as that hole. Another trick here is take your spring and you just stretch it. So the spring, we're just stretching it straight up. That way it can provide enough pressure or have enough spring just in case it got worn down over the time. So you don't want to bend it, you just want to go straight up and just pull it out some. All right. So the pin, like I said before, we're going to flip it. If you don't know what side was down initially, typically it's the side that doesn't have a circle around it that has been made by the plastic piece that goes on top. So as you see this, there's no circle. Flip it over and there's a circle. That circle is made by that spring guard, by this black spring guard here. All right, so now we have all that. Let's flip the pin. So it's the pin followed by the spring followed by the guard. So this part here is a little shiny than the others. So that's where the spring guard was rubbing back and forth. So I'm just gonna put it back in the same spot. All right, and at this point, it probably wouldn't hurt to add a little oil just so it's not like rough. So as you can see, it's locking in place now. It can be a little bit of movement, but that's not much. All right, so we're putting the back gears on here. So you have to match up the bolts, of course. Then we're gonna put our bolts in. Now we want the, it's part numbers right here on the top. We want these part numbers to be lined up with the lock, because when you put the adjuster back on, it's going to be with the part numbers facing up. All right, so when we go to tighten it up, we're going to go like we do with lug nuts. You don't want to go around, you want to go across, up, down. So here, 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 here. That way it provides you more of a even, I guess, yeah, more of an even tighten up. All right, so now with it on, you wanna make sure that the lip is not hanging over and it's flush all the way around. Now we can start tightening. So I'm not torquing yet because I'm gonna have to be able to get a grip on this thing. All right, so a rule of thumb I like to do is or like to follow is, I tighten them how tight they were to get off. So if they were pretty tight to get off, I wanna tighten them pretty tight if I don't have any torque specs. I mean, ideally you wanna go by torque specs. But I did match some of these up and hopefully that will work. All right, so now we have to put the cam adjuster back into the bank. So as I mentioned before, there are some part numbers on the top there, and you wanna make sure that that is facing up. Bracket or locking mechanism in place. You can't really put it any other way. Alright, so on this tool there are some notches here and here. And that goes over these guides. Not like this, I'm just showing you that it, how it goes over it. And then that will keep it in place and flush on that. So there's one on both sides, and that's what we're gonna put in now. Alright, so as I said before, when you install this, you wanna make sure that the part numbers are up, facing up. On there, not tighten it up, just putting it back on there so this part doesn't fall off. All right, so you want to leave it to where this can turn because this has to be lined up. All right, so these slits here on the back side, so it's facing this way, you want to make sure you have the left side facing you, and then this is going to be the back side, so these slits here will go into these slits a certain way, only one way, and that makes sure that the timing is correct. So as we put in this plate on, we want to see how it would go in there correctly. So as you can see, this plate is locked, can't move. So that means it's in the right timing position. And this is flush against this, so everything is good. So now we can tighten up this bolt. All right, so using an 18 millimeter, we're gonna tighten this up. As a check, we wanna make sure that we put our locking plate on the back just to ensure that everything is still in the right position. So it should fit in there like that. If that doesn't fit, then your camshafts are incorrect. And we need to rotate the crankshaft to get it at the proper degree of 40 degrees. All right, with that locked, let's go ahead and tighten our bolt with the 18 millimeter. All right, so you have to torque down the bolt that attaches the cam adjuster to the camshaft. The torque spec for that is 45 newton meters or 33.16 foot-pounds of torque. So now we're going to take off the tool that allowed it to be compressed. Well, I guess we can't really take it off until I take this off, but we can loosen it up. Well, now that everything is torqued, we can take this off, take off our camshaft lock, as well as the back one, and our front plate. You want to be very careful because you don't want to drop anything into the engine. So things have shifted a little bit since I took it out, which is suspected because this wasn't exactly proper. All right, take this off that locks the camshaft. Take off your tension, backlash, compression tensioner. All right, now we're gonna put back on the timing cover. I'm gonna wipe this dirt away. Make sure you wipe away just so there's no dirt and we get a good seal. And you wanna make sure you don't wipe any dirt into the engine. All right, so let's get the timing cover back on here. Make sure your harness is all out the way. So what I did here, these little rings, one came off. So you wanna make sure that that doesn't happen when you're pushing it in, because that will block your oil. So just take your time, get it on there. All right, make sure nothing is stuck up in there. Everything is sealed properly. Front cover's on. All right, now we're gonna put the bolts back into the timing cover. Remember, there's five of them. And these are the bolts. The black ones. But they're black for me. I don't know if they're gonna be black for you, but these are the bolts from the front cover. And they use the T30 torque bit as well. All right, so at the bottom there, you can see there's two holes next to each other. You wanna make sure that you're putting the bolt for the timing cover at the very bottom one, and then the one that's above it is for the ground strap. All right, and the last bolt goes down here in the corner, right behind this harness. I'm gonna go ahead and tighten this one while I have it accessible. All right, now that we have everything torqued down, you can plug in your ground strap as well as your harness and then reattach the bracket. All right, now we have to put the spark plugs back in. All right, so now that we have everything back on the front, the timing cover, let's do a few rotations of the crankshaft just to make sure everything is copacetic. Looking good to me. All right, so let's put the valve cover on. All right, I'm just gonna wipe down the gasket just in case there is some debris that build up after being out. All right, so let's put it back on. The hardest part of this is the harness. So I'm putting in the corner of the valve cover underneath the harness and then moving it accordingly. Okay, and that did the trick. Perfect. All right, so that's perfect, except I forgot the spark plug tube gasket. God damn it. Let's start bolting in. All right, just for time purposes, I'm going to use power tool, but I'm not going to tighten it by any means. Trying to get the process going a little faster. All right, now we're going to put in the spark plug. Now it's time for the coil packs. But first, don't forget to button up this bracket here. So let me get that If you remember from a previous video, I numbered my coil packs. I'm gonna put them back according to that number. This side being 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is number 7. All right, so we finally finished it. We installed the cam adjuster on the driver's side bank. So let's see what we get. Let's crank it up, see if everything works. Good deal. Well, there you have it, folks. Another episode. Thanks for checking out this series. If you enjoyed it, please give all 3 videos a thumbs up. And until next time, I'm out.